Why do biologists need math? Biology is the study of the living world. And in order to understand the principles of life, we need to be able to interpret the world around us. Math is the tool that allows biologists to quantify and measure all the different aspects of life. Let's take a brief look at some ways that biologists use math. Let's say you manage a forest and want to know how much lumber you can harvest from each tree. First off, you can calculate the height of a tree using trigonometry. You can then measure the circumference of the tree and calculate its cross-sectional area. From this information, you can determine how to have the log milled so as to maximize the amount of lumber obtained. You can make these calculations before cutting down the tree so as to make sound decisions. What if you wanted to know how much a population of individuals varied in weight? You might be in charge of a population of mice for research, which had been fed something like yummy chow. First, you could weigh each mouse. Then you could find the average weight, otherwise known as the mean, by adding up all the weight values and dividing by the number of mice. Next, you could calculate the weight range by finding the difference between the highest and lowest weight values. And finally, you could calculate what percentage this variation in weight was of the mean. But what if you wanted to know whether one type of food resulted in bigger mice? Then, still using math, you could make the same measurements on another group of mice who had been fed super yummy chow. You could then find out how much one population varied from another. Did the mean weight vary, or was a larger range of weights realized? Was the variation the same percentage of mean weight? If you wanted, you could then ask the question about the differences you measured and use statistical tools of math to determine if the difference was big enough to not have happened by chance. Are the mice as a group who are fed different chow really different, or did the difference just happen by chance? Lots of people get the flu, and epidemiologists track these cases each season using math. They want to determine the incidences, new cases occurring, and the frequency, number of cases that already exist. Tracking these numbers helps determine the rate of change, number of new cases over time. Do we have an outbreak of flu right now? To answer this, we need to determine if we are experiencing an increased rate of incidences in the area. Measuring a phenomenon and then determining its rate of appearance or disappearance over time can help us to answer these questions. Using linear and nonlinear algebra, you can look at how one thing is correlated to another. For example, you might question just how drinking coffee is related to the number of hours you sleep at night. You could vary the amount of coffee you drink in a day and measure the number of hours you sleep that night. After a number of days varying the coffee intake and measuring the hours of sleep, a graph could be constructed. Does a linear negative relationship exist in which increasing coffee intake reduces the hours slept? Maybe there's no correlation between the amount of coffee and the hours of sleep. You can investigate all of this using math. If a correlation is established, then you could investigate whether one thing is causing another by conducting experiments with controls. Maybe you're interested in how fast something is changing over time and also want to know if the rate of change is increasing, staying the same, or decreasing. Calculus can help us with this. For example, you mow your lawn in the summer and only want to mow when you have to. How fast is the grass growing? And will it be growing at an exponential rate? Or will that rate vary throughout the season with rainfall and other environmental factors? What will the total amount of grass cuttings be that you have to bag and carry off to the compost pile? Using calculus would allow you to find answers to these questions. When studying biology, it's helpful to understand the character and dynamics of what we observe. The many powers of mathematical techniques help us do just that. In later videos, we'll take a deeper look at these principles and explain how you can use math to study biology.